practically all cybersecurity jobs require at least a basic understanding of IT. But you might be in a job right now that doesn't require IT skills. If that's the case and you don't already know IT fundamentals, now's the time to come up to speed. IT basics can be divided into six broad categories: computer hardware and peripherals, operating systems, office productivity software, servers, networking, and coding. As I walk through these areas, ask yourself how well you know them. All of them can be important to a successful cybersecurity career. Computer hardware and peripherals includes processors, hard drives, memory, printers, and other items. These might not seem like they're related to security, but all of these items can be the source of security problems. For instance, design flaws in computer processors called Spectre and Meltdown made headlines because they could allow attackers to capture information they shouldn't be able to access. A cybersecurity professional needs to have at least a fundamental understanding of what these items are and how they work. A working understanding of operating systems like Windows, Linux, and macOS is also important. All of these operating systems are susceptible to vulnerabilities if they're not patched or configured correctly. If you have a home computer, then you probably have a basic knowledge of at least one operating system. But you might want to go a little deeper if you're planning on a cybersecurity career. Office productivity software like word processing, spreadsheet, and presentation applications can also be sources of security problems. For instance, some of these applications can run code called macros that can be malicious. Not only should you know how to use these applications, you should have a good understanding of how they can be configured to be more secure. Servers are special-purpose systems like Windows domain controllers, web servers, and DNS servers. These are often targeted by attackers because they contain valuable data and can give access to other systems or parts of the network. You'll need to have at least a general idea of what various servers can do and the role they play in network security. Networking refers to all of the protocols and technologies related to computer networks. This includes LANs, WANs, Wi-Fi, TCP/IP, DNS, DHCP, and more. Weaknesses in the network can allow attackers to gain unauthorized access to systems and networks, or capture data moving between systems. If you don't have a basic understanding of how networks operate, then I recommend focusing on this one. And coding includes understanding of at least basic coding concepts like variables and loops, and familiarity with one or more popular scripting languages like HTML, Python, JavaScript, or PowerShell. Scripts can be useful or malicious. They can help automate tedious tasks, or they can be used to attack systems or networks. You will find many ways to apply coding knowledge throughout a cybersecurity career. If you know you have knowledge gaps when it comes to IT fundamentals, take the time to educate yourself. Then find ways to apply your new knowledge, either at work or at home. You'll need this understanding of IT basics when you transition to a cybersecurity career. The best way to learn is by doing. And if you want to really understand IT, you'll benefit more by doing an IT job than studying on your own or going to a tech school. Plus, this way you'll earn while you learn versus paying for training. A great example of an entry-level job that will give you a crash course in everything IT is a help desk technician. While you'll need at least a year of IT experience to work on an IT help desk, soft skills like good verbal communication, organization, and time management are almost as important. You'll encounter real-world problems that will force you to learn new IT concepts you might not have learned otherwise. You should be able to find plenty of entry-level IT jobs by searching job sites like LinkedIn for entry-level IT. You may also run across IT intern jobs, which are also entry-level jobs but usually require you to be enrolled in a bachelor's degree program. If you can't find an entry-level job or you still need a little experience, consider volunteering at any organization which needs IT help but can't afford it. They'll appreciate your help and you'll gain skills and experience. Of course, if you're already mid-career in a different field, starting an entry-level IT job may be a step down in pay, not to mention pride. While an entry-level IT job can help you gain the skills you need for a cybersecurity career, it might not be the right move for you. Look at your career plan and decide if that's the way you want to go.